Good morning students. Today we will be discussing the topic operations on large number. There are four basic operations on large numbers. Okay, the first one is addition, subtraction, multiplication, and the last one is division. Now let us move on to the first one, that is addition. Now before starting the actual addition, we will see few key points which we need to remember. The first one is the numbers to be added are called the addends. That means the two numbers or more than two numbers which we are going to add are known as addend. Then the second one is the result of addition is called the sum. That is the answer of addition. After adding two or more numbers, the answer or the result is known as the sum. Now we'll just see a small example. Add 5436289 and 2578657. First of all, we'll just make the place value column like this: ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, and 10 lakh. After making this, we'll arrange the digits in accordance to their place values. After arranging them, we will simply add and find the result. So this is our final answer, which we can call as the sum. Okay, now moving on to subtraction. In subtraction also we need to see few key points. The first one is the larger number from which we subtract is known as the minuend. We all know that for subtraction, one number should be larger and the other should be smaller. So the larger number is known as minuend, and the number which is subtracted from the larger number or the smaller number is known as subtrahend. Now, after subtraction, there comes an answer. That answer or that result is known as the difference. Moving on to the example of subtraction. Subtract 2736879 from 5453 42568. Now first we have to identify which is minuend and which is subtrahend. That is, the greater number will be the minuend and the smaller number will be the subtrahend. Now we can clearly see that 5342568 is the minuend, and 2736879 is the subtrahend. Again we will be making the place value columns here, and then we will just arrange both the numbers or both the digits in the column. Then we will subtract. Now here just look at the pattern, or just look at the question. Few things I have written here in pencil. Now what are all these? As we know, we cannot subtract a greater number from a smaller number. Here we can see in the ones place it is 8 and 9. We cannot subtract 9 from 8. So we will be borrowing 1 from 6 from the tens place to 8, and it will become 18, as you can see here. And this 9 will be subtracted from the number, that is the new number 18. Now moving on to the second. Tens place, now the number is 5. And 7, we cannot subtract 7 from 5. Then we will again be taking, borrowing indeed from the number 5, and it will become 15. So we will be subtracting 7 from 15. The same way, we will be borrowing until and unless the number reaches to be equal to the number below, or it should be greater to the number below. After subtracting, this will be our final answer, which we can call as the difference.